In these sessions, I will discuss how the statistic distribution applies to the real-life quality engineering. Assume you are a company, you plan to order a batch of steel reinforcement bars, like the picture here. And the minimum strength for the bars is 30,000 kg. And also, you require the maximum probability for the strength of the bar smaller than the minimum requirement to be less than 0.1%. Assume you are a quality control engineer. You need to determine a vendor A who provides a batch of reinforcement bars with the mean strength of 33.5 thousand kilograms and a standard deviation of 2,000 kilograms. Assume the distribution of the strength is normal distributions, and you need to determine whether the samples from this vendor A is qualified for your requirement. Because it is assumed normal distributions, you can use the mean value and the standard deviation to determine what is the unqualified probability and whether the unqualified probability is smaller than the requirement 0.1%. Distribution, the mean of the vendor A's samples center at 33.5 and the standard deviation is 2. The minimum requirement is 30,000 kilograms. So the problem can be reformatted into a question: what is the cumulative probability for this distribution to be smaller than 30? And easy, you can use the previous table, but this is not a standard normal distribution, so you need to reformat output Y into standard normal distribution to Z using the previous given equation, and then you can apply the table to find out what is the value. So for the previous examples, you may find out that the cumulative probability for the current batch is greater than the requirement 0.1%. As a vendor, you need to think of how to improve your product in such a way it can be accepted to the company. Right now, the distribution is not acceptable. So there are two methods you can think of to improve your products. To meet the requirements, you can either increase the mean but maintain the standard deviation. I can use this figure to show that. As I've shown here, for current distributions, it's like the blue distribution. The probability for the strength smaller than 30,000 kilograms is greater than 0.1%. So how do you do? The first method is simply shift the distribution toward the right side. Then you don't need to change the standard deviation. You don't need to change the width of the distribution. But by shift the mean value to a greater number, you can reduce the probability for Y smaller than 30 to within 0.1%. However, if you use the previous method, you shift the mean to a larger value, in the actual case, stands for you need to increase the overall strength. For steel bar, the most common way is to increase the size, but it will associate it with the increase of cost as well. There is another method that can change your distribution to make your product satisfy the requirement. This is by changing the distribution, by reducing the standard deviation of your distributions. The current distribution center at 33.5. However, the standard distribution is too big. The disqualified rate is over the requirement. If you can reduce the standard deviation to a smaller number, like the red line over here, in such a way that the probability for Y to be smaller than 30,000 kilograms will satisfy the 0.1%, then you can fulfill the requirement as well. How do you reduce the standard deviations, and what kind of numbers is small enough to meet the requirement? I'll let you practice to see if you can find a number. So overall, we mentioned two methods to adjust your output distribution to fulfill the strength requirement. In summary, the first one is move the center of the distribution to a larger place, like this one, to meet the strength requirement. However, this method in applications simply stands for increase the diameter of the bar. If you increase the diameter of the bar, which means you need to spend more cost. And the second method, reduce the distribution rather than move the center of the distribution, like this blue line over here, to satisfy the strength requirement. As I mentioned, there are two ways to reduce the deviation. The first one is using tolerance control, better machine, better material, better technicians. However, again, the cost will increase. Now the second possible method is using parameter design. And this is the method I mentioned, try to find the optimum parameters in such a way the distribution can be reduced. There's another statistical measures for process capabilities, which is related to output distribution. This is called process capability index. Process capability index is the ability of a process to produce an output within a specification range. Most of the case, in quality controls, you need to check whether your output is within a given range, such as upper specification limit and lower specification limit, like this one. This is the output requirement. And if a process can be assumed to be normal distributed, you can use their mean and standard deviation to find out the distributions. If the process mean is centered at the target, and the process capability index is the tolerance range, which is the upper specification limit minus the lower specification limit, divided by the 6 times of standard deviation of your distribution. Assume you have two processes, process A, which is blue line, and process B. They all centered at the target, but have different standard deviations. For process A, it has a larger standard deviation, therefore you can see the unqualified probability will be larger than process B, because process B has a smaller standard deviation. CP can give a measures to determine which process is better by dividing the tolerance range over 6 times of standard deviation. You can find out the CP of process B is better than the CP of process A. For larger CP stands for the process can provide a higher accepted rate when fabricating the parts. In case your specification only contains an upper limit like this one, so your distribution has to be smaller than a certain number over here, M plus delta. M is the target. And your distribution is like the red line over here, with the center at Y bar and the standard deviation of S. So the CP for a process with the upper limit only will be the distance between the upper limit here to the mean of your distribution, divided by the 3 times of standard deviation, this one. And this is called CP for upper limit only. Similarly, for a specification that consists of a lower limit only, the corresponding equations is shown here. If this process has to within a certain limit, however, your distribution is not centered right at the target, the corresponding process capability is called CPK. You need to consider the upper limit and lower limit just like what you did in the previous two criteria, and find out what is the corresponding value, and the minimum value between these two will be the value of CPK.